Ok. All right. Encre noire. Yes. Oh. What is this all about? What is this? Bonjour, fragrance lovers. Welcome back to my little sofa. I hope you're well. I'm very well too. Before the video started, I'm so sorry to put that at the beginning, but just to let you know because I just created it, this won't happen again, I promise. I just created a uTip account, so you can find the link in the little description. If you want to support the channel and support me as well, you can just watch free advertising and then it will give me a little tip. Don't want to do it, it's okay. If you do it, I love you. Anyway, let's go. Okay, so today we are talking about Lalique encre noire. And couldn't wait to do it because I never tried it. I didn't know what to expect. So for me, it was a full discovery. So I didn't know at all what to expect. And I've checked the prices and I was like, oh! Okay, so I was like, you know what, I'm gonna do review. If I like one, I will purchase one. So at the end of the video, I'm gonna tell you which one I'm gonna purchase or not, because maybe it's not worth it. Let me guide you through Encre Noire Classique, the sport and the extreme, and tell you which one is the best for me and which one would suit you the most. Right, so first of all, let's start with Encre Noire, this little bottle here. So, bottle quite classic. We're just gonna judge the bottle classic before, because this is what I always do. I like to talk about packaging. The bottle is classic, it's black, it's got a wooden cap. I mean, nothing to say about that. I'm expecting something quite deep, something quite intense with this, but also something that it probably would be a classic for me. The one now, you've got like the little red color in there and a bit lighter color of the bottle. What really shocked me with this is it really reminds me Chanel, the Allure range. When I've seen that, I was like, ah, oh, you know, Prada as well, Luna Rossa and things like that. So I was like, okay, maybe more citrusy, something like that. And the extreme, of course. So again, makes me think of Chanel, but the brand just over there make me think of something quite incensey, probably something incensey or something a bit more boozy. That's what I saw. Let's go to the tea now and let's talk about the composition. Okay, first one, encre noire. So what do we have in the composition? Head cypress, so a kind of like piney, I would say, scent, green aromat. You have vetiver. Vetiver smell always like very masculine, nearly like barbershop kind of thing, and smells very earthy. And then you have, and sometimes smell a bit more smoky. And then you have musk and cashmere wood. So meaning this wood is going to be a bit more comforting, cocooning, maybe a bit more silky. This is what I expected. It's a woody aromatic fragrance, very smoky. The first thing that I was really shocked when I sprayed it was power. I was like, whoa. A very strong, powerful opening, and I was quite shocked. And this opening is quite rare because it was full of greenness. It's like a lot of pine trees and suddenly exploding to your face. It also had a little bit of that licorice type of scent, so it made me think nearly like probably the woods, the cashmere wood that is giving that. Overall, the scent smelled very thick, a lot of thickness, so it's not something light at all. So really matching the color of the bottle, very deep, very intense, with a very cold undertone. So it's not like warming and cocooning to me, it's more like a cold undertone. And I don't know, like very very green, and the vetiver plus the cypress give like an intense greenness. So if you don't like green, you're not gonna like this fragrance at all. The dry down gave me something very inky, nearly metallic. So I don't know if I'm the only one to have this kind of smell, but I felt something quite metallic, like nearly like a bit blood, like the ink smelled like this. I was very confused, but then it was a bit gone, and you still have that greenness over there, very silky, a greenness. So I do really enjoy it. I quite enjoyed the composition. I thought that was quite different to have such a strong opening. However, it's something that I've seen before. Ingrid in like Cashmere Woods, I think it really gives like something very elegant. But it's something that I've seen before. It nearly makes me think of a crossover between Sycamore from Chanel and Terre d'Hermès. Maybe less fruity than Terre d'Hermès and less lighthearted than Sycamore. So for that, I would probably put like a 2/3 in the composition because I've and seen that. For the sport one, quite a surprise because at the beginning when I sprayed it, I couldn't feel the classic at all anymore. Which was really strange. So it's a woody aquatic for this one. So composition just there, nutmeg, bergamot, a grapefruit for the opening. So quite bright opening. And you have watery note, lavender and cypress. So again, this very greenness that is here, a bit more soothing, comforting, and maybe a bit more floral as well tone. And then you have the cashmere wood, the vetiver and the musk that are there as a backbone. So maybe that's why it's quite not as close to the classic entre noir, because really the vetiver is more there as supporting the other ingredient more than the star of the show. So it definitely does smell a bit aquatic to me. However, for me, it smells a bit more delicate, I would say, because the lavender gives like a slightly floral tone to me, so which I quite enjoy. I thought as well the fact that the citrus was there were giving like a more bitterness to the fragrance. It's not as bomb as the Encre Noir classic would be. It's a bit more softened in the composition. Mixing kind of an aquatic with a very green scent was really interesting. And I really enjoy it. I think the composition for me is a hit for this one because it's something a bit different. It's not too much of that greenness. It's balanced with some citrus and florals, which is really nice. So for me, that's a 3/3 for the composition. And for the extreme, so that's the one I was expecting something a bit more incensey and definitely right because you've got bergamot LME resin and cypress. So it smells quite thick as well. This one, very thick. Nearly like a strong, warm and licorice cocktail. Incense, orris and vetiver, and the incense mixed with the orris gives like a smoky, powdery tone to the fragrance. And then you have benzoin, sandalwood and patchouli. And benzoin gives really that very mysterious vibe always with the incense. So, not a surprise at all. Like, when I told you when I've seen Extreme, I was completely expecting that. I was like, they're gonna do like an incense version of their Encre Noir. I guess like, you know, it's working. It nearly makes me think of what Hermès did with Terre d'Hermès as well, the intense vetiver, like a bit more smoky, churchy, mysterious. Definitely the same idea with the Extreme over there. However, I really could smell a bit more sensitivity in this one, a bit more thickness, roundness, smoothiness with the benzoin. Composition overall, I felt was a bit more acidic. There's slightly something acidic in there. It's a bit more balanced than the classic Encre Noir. So for me, the composition is a bit more interesting in there. It's not as simple. So I would put a 3/3 over this one as well. Let's talk about how the fragrance makes me feel. For the first one, I could really see the will of doing something iconic, timeless, maybe not the most original composition I've seen, but something that definitely works. However, you really have this ink smell that for me gives like a much more deepness than any classic fragrances. Classic smell, very qualitative. Which is so surprising. Come on, look at this price. Like, I could see something very deep and very rich. However, this type of scent for me are a bit not as young for a young audience. I would say the 30s type of age, I would see someone like that with a lot of character. It makes me think nearly of like a very classic tuxedo. It's with someone a bit more wild, I would say, a bit intriguing from all the three, is the most trendy one. Huh? You really need to enjoy that foresty, wild kind of feeling. Overall, what I like is it uses a lot of green. greenness and sometimes green fragrance or lacking of modernity. This one is very modern, slightly cozy. Nully make me think of, you know, like if you had to pick timeless classic scent, you probably get like a Bleu de Chanel. For me, that's different in the smell, but it's the same category of fragrance. Sophisticated, it's slightly sensual. A bit more for every day, this scent. I would wear it every day. I would say if you want to wear it every day, don't overspray it. Absolutely don't, because you're gonna get intoxicated by this flawless greenness at the beginning. Really, really, it's a lot, trust me. But with the time, it goes very smooth. The scent by itself, I would give it a 3/4 because it's working, but it's got nothing really impressive to me. And then the sport one, because for me it doesn't match the name. I mean, I'm explaining myself. For me, it doesn't smell sporty. I can see that very aquatic, piney scent, but for me it's very classy. Like, it smells also very linear. It doesn't move with the time. That's what I've seen with this scent, at least on me. I feel that it was more summer, springtime friendly, but also could be a good everyday scent for all year round. I felt this one had more sensitivity than the other one, more silkiness, suppleness. You can wear it to the gym. Why not with this watery note? But for me, it's really sophisticated. Like, it's nice. I felt that it was a bit also like changing from all the scent that I usually smell. It really have that powdery sensitivity. I like it. I really like it. And it's masculine, but not that much. So that I really enjoy, but I would put a 3/4. I would say 3.5, I would say, for this one over 4, because I prefer this from the classic Encre Noire, definitely. And then the extreme is more, there's no surprise for me, like I was expecting that, but overall is a bit more mature, I would say, than the other one. It's something that is a bit more bitter as well, and I felt that was again more wilder. I felt for me that was the hipster of the three of those. You've got the little trendy, mature one, show value, safe value, and the first one. Second one a bit more sensitive, poetic maybe. And this one for me was a bit more hype. Hipster, I would see like a beard with it, something quite like sharp and a strong man, masculine. I don't know, yeah, I felt it was a bit more punchy, but still with a sense of fashion. It's much more richer, slightly more dusty, more warmer than the other one, definitely. If that was me doing the extreme version of Encre Noire, I would have put rum in it. I would have made it more boozy. But that's me, I'm not the perfumer, so not as the classic, I would say. Because it's nice, but voilà. For the longevity, so for me, you can't judge a fragrance by its longevity, and that's why when I want to rate a longevity, I take my feeling and I take other one's feeling. So I've been looking around the comments, the forums, what they're saying about longevity. This was the most contrasted thing I've ever seen in my life. Like, people saying that it lasts absolutely nothing on them, and other people saying like it's completely beast on them. A river in between the two. For me, I mean, it's been a good 4-5 hours that I have it on, that I can still smell it, but it's quite discreet. So even if it was really beast mode, the first one, the Encre Noire, the original, at the beginning, it stays quite discreet on me. It's not really exceptional longevity on me. It's moderate, I would say, quite moderate. But however, you need to be quite gentle with the first application, because it's quite beast at the beginning, definitely. But after, yeah, moderate, but I still can smell it on me. For the sport one, I would say even less than the Encre Noire. Well, on me, much less. Like, I barely can smell it. However, quite good, because it's been a few hours and it's a sporty version, so it's normal that it doesn't stay as long as the original. So I was expecting that, so I'm not disappointing. And it didn't really last that much, but yeah, it was exactly the same. is for me a bit more. However, I've put it there and always there is staying a bit more longer because the veins are very pulsating over there, so that's why it's staying more longer. So always spray there because it stays more longer. But yeah, I found the liver acidity was a bit higher than the other one. Thank God, because it's supposed to be an extreme, so it's supposed to be a bit more sillage. So voilà. Okay, let me give you my conclusion on that. So for the encre noire classic, I got a grade of 7/10, which I think is a good grade for this fragrance. I mean, it's a nice timeless classic with a lot of green undertone, which is really nice, and I love vetiver. So, you know, I didn't see anything exceptional in this fragrance. I think it's definitely a must have because for the price and for the good quality of ingredient give, I think definitely is good. But yeah, it's nice. Sport, I would give it an 8/10. So even though it lasts less, I prefer the scent of this because it's my personal opinion. So the fact that there's some silkiness and suppleness to this fragrance give really like an added value to it. And I've seen a lot of vetiver fragrance. I'm passionate with vetiver, and I saw if I had to get one of those, I will get probably more drawn to this one because the first one is something that I smelled before. This one was a bit of a surprise. I was surprised when I smelled it, so a good surprise. So for me, it was a little bit upper point. And finally, the extreme that got a 7 as well. 7, the same as rate as the encre noire. I would go, if I would be a bit picky, I would say probably 7.5 because I think this one's got a bit more of personality for me than the encre noire classic. The creaminess of it make it more attractive to me. Hello? No, I can't. I hope somebody can open the door. Am I gonna purchase it? Yes, 100% I'm gonna buy one. I mean, for this price. I mean, I think they're really good value for a very qualitative scent. So, for that price, I mean, there's nothing to complain about. I want it. Seriously? Okay, let me just get it. Sorry. I just received something. I might open it with you actually. Voilà. So I hope everyone is well and I will see you very soon. Bye now.